Mr. Bernanke, if you don't mind, would you tell me whether or not you do your own shopping at the grocery store?
Yes, I do.
Okay, so you're aware of the prices. But, you know, this argument that prices are going up about 2%, nobody believes it. You know, and the old CPI says prices are going up at 9%. So they believe this. And people on fixed incomes, they're really hurting. The middle class is really hurting because their inflation rate is very much higher than the government tries to tell them. And that's why they lose trust in government. You took over the Fed in 2006. I have a silver ounce here. And this ounce of silver back in 2006 would buy over 4 gallons of gasoline. Today it'll buy almost 11 gallons of gasoline. That's preservation of value, and that's what the market has always said should be money. Money comes into effect in a natural way, not in an edict, not by fiat, by governments declaring it is money. You know, as much as I would like to do something with the Fed, I say the Fed's going to self-destruct eventually anyway when the money's gone. But why wouldn't we legalize competing currencies? Why couldn't people save, put this in a mattress and get 4 or 5 times much of the value in a few years? So the record of what you've done in the last 6 years is destroy the value of real money.
First of all, good to see you again, Congressman Paul. Just one word on the inflation. Of course, those numbers are constructed by the Bureau of Labor Statistics, not by the Fed. They're independently constructed, and I think they're done in a very serious and thoughtful way. On alternative currencies, nobody prevents you from holding silver or gold if you want to. It's perfectly legal to do that. And you're also happy to – it's also perfectly fine to hold other currencies, euros or yen or whatever else. So in that respect, you can do that, and I'd be happy to talk to you about
other options. But, Mr. Chairman, that's not money. I mean, when you pay taxes to buy a coin or you have a capital gains tax, when it's not – if you have to settle a lawsuit, it's always settled in depreciating Federal Reserve notes. It's never settled in the real contract. So that's nothing near money. The Federal Reserve is given a responsibility to protect the value of the dollar. That's what stable prices are all about. We don't even have a definition of a dollar. You know, we ask about the definition of a dollar, and I say, oh, it's whatever it's by. Well, every single day it buys less than the next day. And to me, it's sort of like building an economy and having economic planning like a builder had a yardstick that changed its value every single day. I mean, just think of the kind of a building we have. I guess over the last 30 or 40 years, I have criticized the Fed on occasion. But the Congress deserves some criticism, too. The Federal Reserve is a creature of the Congress, and if we don't know what the Fed is doing, we have the authority, and we certainly have the authority to pursue a lot more oversight, which I would like to see. So although the Fed is on the receiving end, and I think rightfully so when you look at the record, I mean, the Fed's been around for 99 years, almost a few years before you took it over, and 99%, 98% of the dollar value is gone from the 1913 dollar. So that's not really a very good record. And I think what we're witnessing today is the end stages of a grand experiment. We have a debt-based system. The more debt we have and the more debt the Federal Reserve buys, the more currency they can print. And they monetize this debt. And no wonder we're in a debt crisis. It's worldwide. I think it's something we've never experienced before. And I think the conclusion will be a vindication either for sound money, or if you win the argument and say, yes, we are great managers, we know how to do it, we want the credit for the good times, and we want the credit for getting us out of those good times, I mean, I think within a few years we're going to know. Of course, I'm betting that the market is smarter, commodity money is smarter, nobody's smart enough to have central economic planning. So I'm anxiously waiting for this day for the conclusion because reforms have to come.
Dr. Paul and Chairman Bernanke, you're getting along so marvelously. Ms. Waters, we hope you'll continue this cordiality.